All in all, a disappointing winter for England?
A very disappointing winter. I think, firstly, the World Cup was a real letdown, I suppose, for all of us. Not just, I suppose, players, but supporters and everyone. You know, we played nothing like we should. Well, we expected to play and what we, you know, deserve for the public to watch as well. So that was a letdown. And Caribbean was good in parts, and then a real letdown again at the end. It would have been nice to come away with a series win. But there were some parts in that were good, but like I said, to finish that last test match on a real low coming back, so hopefully we can start the summer a little bit better. Our test cricket hasn't been, I suppose, it's been a lot more consistent than our one day cricket, which is it's a good thing. And also there's been some young players, obviously in particular Ruti and Gary Balance, the way they've played, we're starting to see some progress, I think. You know, and there's some young guys on the edge of that as well in the bowling department that could be pushing as well. So there's some good things that we're doing in Test cricket, and the summer we have now with New Zealand, you know, massively in form, and Australia is exactly what you want as a player. You know, there's things to play for, massive summer. So hopefully Test cricket is where it starts for us going forward again.
But on the back of that, Peter Moore's lost his job. Did that surprise you? Did you feel you'd let him down, or was that always on the cards?
I think when a coach goes as a player, yeah, you try and think what you could have done more. Obviously, Andrew Strauss, when he came in, had to you know, make a decision and felt it was the right thing for us going forward. But yeah, there's no doubt as players, you look back at times and coaches go, that what else could you have done? And at the end of the day, when you cross the line, it's the coaches can't do anything, it's all about the players. So we have to take some responsibility for that. You know, and that's, I suppose, is what's good coming up. There's some big challenges, and as senior players and junior players, we've got things to play for, and hopefully we can get us moving forward again.
What is Farbrace's skills? What could he bring next Thursday to the dressing room, and can he do the job on a permanent basis?
Again, if he wants it, I don't know if he actually wants to do it on a permanent basis. I think, you know, he's always good around the guys. You talk about that relationship between coach and players. As Grant was saying, I think he's that kind of guy that, you know, gets a lot of good stuff out of the players. He knows the young guys well, certainly the Yorkshire boys, and he's got that kind of energy around the group that, you know, it rubs off on people. So yeah, I think it will be good for us. I don't think there'll be a massive amount of change within the dressing room for the New Zealand series. I think there's more responsibility on myself, maybe Jimmy, you know, Brodie, to help Cookie out, you know, with no head guy. So yeah, it's exciting, but yeah, hopefully we can do well for him as well in the next two games.
Usually it's the opposition players coming for May test matches and having to acclimatise, get used to conditions, but it's a little bit for your guys. The side's not going to change that much from the three tests in the Caribbean. They were all pitches with no grass on at all. You know, you've got to get used to the ball moving around, haven't you?
We have. I mean, to be fair, the one good thing was the Duke's ball out in the Caribbean, which did swing certainly for the first 10-20 overs, so that was a bit more like England. And again, the guys that I spoke to have all been back in training, you know, a couple of days off, and they've been in the nets and working hard, and you know, it won't be just a week off. There'll be, you know, guys will be desperate to make sure when we come to Lords we're ready to hit the ground running and have to do that. But there's no doubt there'll be some adjustment, but having grown up in these conditions, you know, it shouldn't be too hard to adjust, and like I said, be ready for a good scrap against New Zealand.
Investec Ashes coming up. I know you're not going to write these guys off. Just every series is important, but for obvious reason, the Ash is huge. Last time they were over, you were the one batsman. Last time they were here, you absolutely stood up to them almost single-handedly. You expect them more of yourself, exactly the same?
Certainly hope so. I mean, that's the plan. Obviously, in English conditions, I still think we've got a good chance. We'll have to play to our best, but yeah, it's exciting, and hopefully I can carry on. I feel like my form's there, even though the West Indies was extreme high and extreme low, but I feel like my batting's in a good place, and you know, it has to be. We talked about with New Zealand's attack, but Australia's attack is just as strong. So we're going to have, as a batting unit, we're going to have to play well, and we need to score big runs. So it's going to be a good challenge for us. But I suppose that's why you play the game, is to test yourself against the best and for the best coming.
And can you blank out as cricketers the last week and everything that's spoken about English cricket and all the fuss and all the, you know, it's on the front page, back pages. Can you just focus in on your job and what the team are trying to do?
That's part of the skill, I think, of being an international cricketer. We have to. And as a senior player, and there's a few of us in that team, is helping those young guys go through this. This summer will be different for some of the younger guys, and we have to help them through that. And you have to look, I mean, that's part of being an England cricketer, I think, bringing, you know, dealing with all that stuff and making sure you can do the skills. And if we do that, then we'll have a good summer.